Salmon Andre's big walrus mustache bristled with boldness when he made a great splash at the 6th London Congress, telling delegates there that he tried for the pole on a flight through the air. Though financed by King Oscar and Alfred Nobel, and trained by John Wise in the Sky Caravel, the Swede put his listeners in a difficult spot. It's daring they uttered, it's folly they thought. Folly be diddle, I've fixed on a goal. I'll float a balloon and fly north to the pole. The trackless expanses and chill Arctic sea and churning escarpments are nothing to me. I'll ride on the wind like a cloud through the sky, while below me the obstacles distantly lie. Let the eloquent flight of the eagle declare that the road to tomorrow's been forged through the air. On Spitsbergen Island, 11 July, the Eagle was launched when the ground crew cut ties. It rose, then it dipped, and some guidelines were torn. Then it lifted again and was safely airborne. Nils Strindberg, Knut Frankel, and Andre the crew, their brave, worried faces soon faded from view. The craft drifted northward and passed out of sight, and for decades none knew what became of the flight. Then on lonely White Island, on cold barren ground, in mid-1930 some relics were found. Old journals reported the Eagle's sad plight. It was forced down on pack ice after 3 days of flight. The crew tried to sledge to their base and to sail, but they fell on the way. Andre's bones told the tale. He leaned back on a rock and looked up at the sky and dreamed of bold schemes till the day that he died. Folly be diddle, I fixed on a goal. I'll float a balloon and fly north to the pole. The trackless expanses and chill Arctic sea and churning escarpments are nothing to me. I'll ride on the wind like a cloud through the sky, while below me the obstacles distantly lie. Let the eloquent flight of the eagle declare that the road to tomorrow's been forged through the air. Folly be diddle, I've fixed on a